It's a fresh wipe and I'm back on Genesis to see how far I can get. But this time I'm playing Ark on the hardest difficulty. I'm going solo on Genesis. So here we are, I'm back playing solo, on Genesis, on MTS. If you're excited about that, make sure to smash the like button, let's see if we can get 10,000 likes on this video, and with that being said, I hope you guys enjoy, and let's get into it. Bullet him. He bullet me as well. Okay, he's dead. Nice. Okay, got some metal tools, parachute, some hide. Nice. Okay, let's put down these two refining forges and get some metal smelting. I want to make myself a smithy and flak armor as soon as possible. So now that I had my base down and I was melting some metal, I decided to go and get a Bloodstalker, probably one of the most important tames on Genesis, and I wanted to get one as soon as possible, so I got some blood packs and I headed out to tame one. Okay, so I've got 88 blood packs, I think that should be enough for a Bloodstalker. I'm not sure what level I can tame with the raids on here, but I should be able to get a pretty high level if I find one. Is there a base here? I hear forges. What is this? There's a guy right there. If I have C4, I could blow into this. They have a fabricator, no turrets yet. I'll put down a map marker so I know where it is. 8080. These guys are probably about to get turrets because they have a fabricator, so I'm gonna see if I can hurry up, get a Bloodstalker, probably any level will do. And then I can get some polymer, some silica, and I should be able to make some C4. But yeah, let's keep looking and hopefully we'll find a Bloodstalker. Okay, so I finally found one, level 50 male Bloodstalker. It took me quite a while, but I'm probably gonna tame this one even though it's kind of a low level. I'm gonna shoot it quickly so it actually drops down to the ground and then I can tame it. Okay, never mind. That doesn't work anymore. Oh, here we go. They did actually nerf these and they have less range, so that might be the reason why it's not working. I probably need to get closer to it, so I'm just gonna build up a small like ladder going up and we'll just parachute to it. Alright, fingers crossed, this should work. If not, they might just have to make it a bit higher. Come on. Suck me. There we go. I should have enough for this, no problem. Yeah, it's taming pretty quick. Level 50 Bloodstalker, what's the stats on it? 900 health. Not the best, but yeah. It's a Bloodstalker. And there we go. And that didn't even take that many blood packs. It only took about 30, I think. Something like that. 30, 40 blood packs. There we go, fabricator's done. I'm just gonna put it on top of the base for now. Okay, let's go. I got a bed, 5C4, 3 sets of flak. I think I should be able to raid it, but we'll see. Gonna leave my Bloodstalker right here, hopefully no one finds him. Get the bed down. So yeah, I think I'm just gonna go to the left, blow up those two turrets, and hopefully I get them both with C4, because they might not. Oh, I died. I died, but I got the C4 down. We should be fine. As long as they don't come back in this 50 seconds, we should be okay. There we go, got my body. Yeah, that got both of those turrets. Got three of them actually. Is this one pin coded? It is pin coded. Yeah, I'll just run past. We'll go right here. Can I get the door actually? It's right here. No, I think I'm just gonna go through the wall right here. Turret should be off. Yeah, turret's offline. Let me go and get my kit from my Bloodstalker. Nothing on him. Another guy right here. Okay, a lot of metal, narcotics. Where is the smithy? There we go, smithy's here. Some paste. One grenade, 112 blood bags, that's nice. But that's pretty much about it. I don't have that much weight actually on my Bloodstalker. Let's get the bullets. Nothing good to be honest. Bunch of oil, bunch of silk. Some metal, but not really what I was hoping for. No turrets, no silica. I'll just get as much of this back to base as I can. I'm actually gonna blow up this turret as well. Get the ammo from it. So after getting all that metal back to base, I actually had enough to make a cliff platform, which is exactly what I needed to move to the base location I wanted. So I crafted that and I went to set up my new base. The spot I want should be somewhere around here. It's actually on the underside of one of these rocks. That might be it right there, I'm not really sure. No, that's not it. Yeah, I think that's it. Yeah, this right here. Let's get this cliff platform down. Like that. Should be good. Let's see if there's a gap here. There is, okay. I need to pick this up. Not much space here, but I don't really need much space anyways. I'm a solo player. This should be fine, I think. Yeah, no gap on that side. Looks good, let's put it down. So yeah, let's go ahead and put down the base. Well, I'm out of silica now, so I think I'm actually gonna go and tame an anglerfish. Should be pretty quick, they're very easy to find on this map. Okay, so I think I can make some turrets now. Maybe two? No, I need to wait for this metal to smelt. But at least we got one turret. Let's go ahead and put this down. I'm not sure how I'm actually gonna build this. And I'll put down the turret right there. I just want to get another turret so they can't just fly up here. But as soon as I have that, I'm gonna see if I can make a mining drill. I should have enough metal for both a turret and a drill. I've got like 240 in every forge. There is also a mission I want to do in the snow. I don't know what it's called. I think it's this one. So this one you can do on Gamma by yourself, and it does actually drop you Fab Snipers. They're not too good, they're only like primitive and ramshackle, but still, having a decent Fab Sniper would be very nice. But yeah, I'll do that in a bit. Now we just want to go and tame a Procoptodon. Oh, got a kangaroo right here. Go, 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 Microraptor. I need stamina. There you go. Okay, he's dead. Why did it take it so long? He did not even have anything. I think this is full of farm though, I kinda wanna kill it. I think it is. He was so slow on it, he wasn't even jumping. This is probably full of metal, then I can take this and transfer back. If it's not, I'm gonna be quite sad. It is... it's full of stone, what? I don't know if that's even worth the hassle trying to transfer back to base. Well, that was kind of unlucky for this guy. I feel a bit bad. Oh no. Is this Procoptodon going to die? Haha, f***ing dumb. I just actually realized that I think there's a mission in the volcano that gives you mining drills. I think it's this one, Magma Medley Melee. So I'm just gonna go and do that. I think it's quite easy on Gamma. The only thing I need is gonna be some flak and maybe some blood packs. And so I went through that mission, but when I got there was actually someone already doing it, so I just decided to wait outside and see if I can make a play on them. I don't know what stage these guys are on, but I'm probably just gonna wait until they finish and maybe try to make Bola play. I don't think I have enough time to go back and get my full kit, so yeah, I'm just gonna make some Bolas, and when they finish, I'm just gonna see if I can Bola them, maybe get myself a mining drill and run away. Oh my. Oh, they just did. Where are they? Oh, I don't see them. Someone's teleporting. I don't know if that's them. Could be. Think it is. Hello, my friend. Torch method, very strong. Very good. Very good mining drill for me. Thank you very much. Here's someone else teleport, so I just want to get this guy a bit further away. Let me put away my torch. That was so dirty. Oh, I feel so bad for that. Oh, I feel so bad. But I needed that drill. Okay. Okay, that's probably about as much metal as I can get. I'm pretty much overweight, but I did get a good amount of metal. Almost 6,000. In case you're wondering, the way I'm farming is pretty much I farm as I would normally farm, and then I just go to a drop, or a mission in this case, and then I just transfer back. It's a bit slower than just normally farming if I had my base here, but it's worth having my base in a much safer spot. I now decided to go and do that mission in the snow to get some fab snipers. I'm not gonna show you the mission itself because it's kind of boring, but I made it, and this is what we got. Okay, so I just completed the mission. It was actually kinda hard, but we got there in the end, and I actually got two fab snipers. I got 131% and 129, so not too bad. It's exactly what I was hoping for, and I actually got two of them, so I'm pretty happy with that. I was thinking about saving up for a 35k crate, but these actually mostly give you tech, which I can't use because we don't have any tech engrams here, so I'm just gonna go ahead and open the 20k. Apparently they've been buffed since last time I opened them, so hopefully we get something nice. I know we can get like fab sniper blueprints, flag blueprints, pretty much everything I need in here, so let's go. Okay, that's not so good. When I got to the swamp cave, there was actually someone about to do it, so I left my megatherium in a box and I went to fight him. There he is. Can't really shoot him from here though. I need to shoot the scuba tank. There we go, got him. Is his megatherium on neutral? No, it's not, okay. I'm probably gonna have to go back and get my megatherium now so I can actually get it. Let's go and check out the body. Where did I kill the guy? Is it this one? Yeah. Oh, Pteranodon. Pretty much a basic kit. I'll keep the kiting because we need that. But this Tyranno is nice. Even though it's a low level, it's probably good to have if I go to different maps. Well, I'm gonna clear out this cave. Unfortunately, I used up all my tech notes and my normal note just ran out. There's a few notes inside the cave though, so I could get those. Oh, 231 compound roll, that's actually very nice. Alright, let's see, how many levels did we get? 3 levels, yeah, that's pretty much about what I expected, considering I don't have a tech note. So as you guys can see, I'm now in Aberration. The reason I'm here is because I want to go and tame a Reaper. I really need one because I want to start doing some missions on Genesis, and it's also going to be nice to have just in general for PvP. But first we need to go and tame a Megalosaurus, so let's go and find one. That's a guy on the Reaper. That's two guys on Reapers. If it was one, I would fight him, but I don't think I have the rockets for two. I mean, I could fight him. But no, there's no way I'm killing both of them. Actually, what time is it? 22:33. It's almost midnight. I actually could go to the surface and get some drops now. I think I'll do that. Here we go, red drop. This can actually give me some pretty nice stuff. I'm expecting flak chest piece or flak leggings, 500 durability. Oh, flak helmet actually. How much durability is it? 271, so pretty bad, but still flag blueprint. Always good to have better armor. But apart from that, I didn't really get anything good. These gauntlets are nice, I guess. And that's pretty much about it. Yeah, I'm gonna go away. It's almost daytime. Get the Megalo tamed. Hopefully no one's killed it. There we go. Megalosaurus tamed. What stats did it get, actually? 320 melee, 6000 healed. Pretty bad, but it should do the job. So guys, I'm gonna have to end the episode here. As always, I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, a like would be appreciated. And yeah, with that being said, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.